In this video, I'll take you through the setup of a 16 extension PBX, of which we'll start with just 8 extensions that will be upgraded to the full 16 extension. And this is going to be a practical field demonstration of a PBX setup. So join me as I take you through this practical demonstration and setup of a PBX system, or what is also called a telephone intercom system.
Here are Patres boxes that I'll be mounting on walls at the various locations where we'll be having the telephone sockets through which we will be connecting the telephone handsets. I will be mounting 8 of these Patres boxes on the walls since we are doing 8 extensions. This is the first of the Patres boxes we'll be mounting at the locations. So with my pencil and my spirit level, let's see how we'll mount it. As I place it on the wall, I will check its alignment using the spirit level. Once it is properly aligned, I will mark the hole positions on the wall. I have here my drilling machine with my concrete bit ready. So I will drill the marked areas, having in mind the length of screws I will be using. These are wall plugs that I'll be putting into each of the drilled holes. I will now use my screw gun with my screws to screw my Patres boss on the wall. So this Patres boss is fixed. By the same process I used in mounting the first Patres box, I went through the same process to mount all the rest 7 bosses at the other socket locations. The next I wish to do is to mount the PBX switch on the wall. So I'll trace these wall mount hole provisions behind the PBX switch to a paper and transfer the markings to the wall. So I'm marking the hole positions from the paper to the wall now. I will now drill the markings on the wall. Again, these are wall plugs I intend to put into each of the drilled holes. So I'll put into each hole a wall plug. I need to hammer them a bit so that they flash properly on the wall. I will now drive in a screw into each wall plug so that I can hang the machine on the screw. So I can now hang the PBX switch on the screws. So the PBX switch is now on the wall. There are a couple of telephone handsets that I need to hang on wall, so I'll use this one to demonstrate how a handset can be wall mounted or hanged on a wall. So we'll first of all remove this base support for placing it on a tabletop and remount at the bottom here, this way. This is how the device will be sitting on the wall when mounted. So we'll have to trace these hole positions onto the wall. So I will use the measuring tape on my spirit level and transfer the hole positions to the wall. I have measured the gap between the two holes, so I would mark it up on the wall. And drill the marked points. As usual, I'll put the wall plugs into the drilled holes. Hammer them to flash on the wall. I'll put in screws. So those are the screws I have driven so far for hanging the telephone. So I'll hang the handset through these holes we traced in creating the hang screws. So it will sit this way. So that does it for hanging of the telephone handsets on the wall. What I'll do next is to run cables from each extension or telephone point to the PBS switch. So through the opening on the ceiling and by my ladder already positioned, I will be dropping the cables from each extension or telephone point all the way down to the PBS switch. Here is the first cable I dropped at the first telephone extension point. I labeled it as 1 and the other end has been dropped at the PBS switch, also labeled as 1, in order to be able to properly identify each cable. The other ends of each of these other cables have been dropped at each of the telephone locations where I created a telephone extension, and I labeled each of them end to end. So I can now conceal all my cable trunkings coming to the extensions in order to keep the wirings nice and tidy. As you can see, I have concealed the cable here as well, just as I have done for the other locations. Let's now do the socket terminations, and I'll use this particular socket to demonstrate the socket termination process. The cable here is labeled number 3, and I'll cut it short now, and then peel it up to reveal the conductors. I'll cut off this excess. Here are the conductors available to us for use, but we'll really use just 2 pairs out of these 4 pairs of conductors. We'll first need to assemble the keystone jack and the faceplate together. Let me explain how the keystone jack will be wired. We will be relying on the color coding in the keystone jack to do this, and so the striped blue conductor will be matched to the striped blue indicated in here on the keystone jack. The solid blue will also come here as directed by the coding. The striped orange will come here and the solid orange will be placed here. With that understanding, let's do the cable placement. So the striped blue will be placed here. The solid blue will follow. The striped orange here. And then the solid orange. So I'll now punch them down using my punch down tool. So this is a fully wired socket, so I can face it up to the wall now and get it screwed. My socket is ready, and through the same process, I wired all the other 7 sockets in my installation. I'll plug in my telephone service cables to each of my phones and plug into the socket. At the PBS side, I will be plugging all these cables from the telephone extensions into the PBS switch. So I'll start plugging them into the switch now. So all my telephone extensions have been well plugged into the PBS switch. When you look at the PBS switch before I made my connections into the setup, you will realize that the device comes with default extension numbers as indicated here, 601 to 616. So we'll be testing the system with the default extension numbers before we later change the extension numbers and other settings through system programming. So coming back to our setup, the lady in your shot would initiate a call to another extension. You can hear the extension ring in the background. The call Hello? Has been picked and a conversation is going on. You can see the excitement on the face of the lady, and that tells you how effective the system is. And so later on, do the system programming to be able to give numbers or assign numbers to each of the extensions to be used in this setup. If you find value in this video, please give this video a thumbs up and also subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next video.